There you go, Starch.
Oh, you startled me.
Don't like these double shifts in CID. They're going forever and it gets well spooky up there, you know.
Yeah, tell me about it. You know, I often wonder how many years I've spent behind this custody desk, especially at night. Worst thing is, it brings back the ghosts.
Ghosts?
Oh, you know, memories.
That's a relief. What memories of the golden days of policing when the public respected the coppers and the hardest thing you ever had to do was give a kid a clout round the ear?
I mean, yeah, coppers still have to learn pretty quickly on the streets nowadays.
And here comes the oldest young copper on the force.
Reg, I'm just telling Gary how I seem to have spent my whole life at Sunhill.
Oh, that's funny you should say that. I spent yesterday going through some old photographs and press clippings of Sunhill.
One of the ghosts, eh, Jew?
Do you know it's 21 years since you joined?
21 years?
Same age as me.
All right, don't rub it in.
Yeah, so I brought some of these in. I thought a couple of the old-timers, could help me to date them and remember some of the incidences.
Oh, not the good old days again.
Yeah, I'm going to do a book one day about Sunhill, and this is just some of the research material.
God, is that you, Sarge?
Yeah. Look at Jim. He looks about 12. Do you know, that was his first ever day in 1983. I was puppy walking him. Maybe the original wooden tops.
Wooden tops?
Yes, an expression coined by CID when referring to uniform. You don't hear it much, these days. Mm.
God, little did Jim know what he was letting himself in for that day.
Morning, Sam.
Welcome aboard.
Thank you, sir. Sarge.
In your car, mate. You got that. C.C. Carver, sir. C.C. Carver, Inspector Deeping.
Sir.
Now listen, watch and learn. Okay, bye, Sarge.
Right. Walkies. I suppose you're going to try for CID if you stick it out.
No, no, not me. I'll stick with the uniform branch.
We'll see.
Oh, my God.
Sure.
Don't go in.
Oh, don't be so ridiculous. Come on. Oh, Christ.
Sit quiet, all right, while we sort this out.
Hey,
yeah,
no,
shut up.
You
don't
think you're doing.
Dave, there's no harm done. There was only
scrumpy.
Sarge, I was...
Silence!
Only... Don't you ever interrupt me,
lady. Don't you realise what the consequences could be?
Yes, Sarge, but...
Silence, don't interrupt me!
That lady, now,
or his parents decide to push this, you, PC Carver, made bloody history. Suspended on your first ruddy day.
Jim nearly got himself suspended. I never thought he'd stay in the job after that first day.
Can you remember when we had two probationers start on the one day? They were so confident they took a bet out on who'd make the first arrest.
Yes. Debbie Keane and Nick Slater.
Well, of course, they made all the mistakes of probationers, and Tony Stamp never let them forget it.
Now, as most of you are already aware, we have got this month's star prize. Debbie and Nick. Yay! Yeah, that's a nice welcome. So who are we going to pair them with to launch their careers?
I don't know what pair I'd like to be with.
Tony, you take Nick.
Such.
And Debbie, put you with Kath, just to be safe.
Right, sir, are you going to pray?
I am.
Right, somebody's just rung this in. Looks like Dave the Rave's at it again.
No name for the informant?
No, he said he didn't want to mix it with a head case like Dave Green, but he reckons we'll have him if we hurry.
Okay, thanks, George.
Sir.
Now, it might not materialise, but if it does, treat it as urgent.
Morning, sir.
Sir.
All right.
They're all posted, unless there was anything you wanted to add.
Yes, Cad's just handed one over. David Green. Anonymous member of the public saw somebody he thinks was Green in Asquith Road yesterday. And, surprise, surprise, Green was driving.
Is that dark blue Granada, sir?
Correct. Registration number Bravo Echo Bravo 955 Yankee.
Yeah, and he's on for a custodial if he's ever caught driving again. So it would be good to keep him off the roads for a while.
Yeah, you know what he's like, though. If he is spotted, he'll put his toe down, so be careful.
Green works at Finnemore's print shop on Asquith Road. Their night shift knocks off at 7.
OK, Tony, have a look up there. Any sign of the vehicle? Sit up and wait. OK, Bob.
Thank you, sir. Right, anyone got anything to add?
No, sir.
Right, on your bikes.
See you there.
We're still on for the first arrest, sir.
Got a head start with this disc one, haven't you?
I've got a head start being me.
Yeah. Go on, then.
Tenner?
I'm off. Yeah,
why not?
Nick, a word, please.
Thank you, sir.
Sarge?
Is that gum you're chewing?
Yes, Sarge.
Well, I don't know what you did in training, but we don't have gum chewing on this relief.
Right, Sarge, whatever you say.
If I see your mouth going up and down, I expect something intelligent to be coming out of it. Understood?
Sarge,
get to work.
Does Sergeant Cryer enjoy humiliating people, then?
He's an old-style copper. Likes things done the right way. So what did you do before this job?
Salesman.
Oh, yeah? Double glazing or pork?
It's all the same thing, isn't it? It's a finance you're selling, not the product. Sign him up for 3 years and wallop, all the day in IB for him.
So why did you quit?
No real challenge. I made the target, sir. I will here as well.
We may be off to a flying start. It's Dave Green's Granada.
Great.
Sit and wait. Discreet surveillance. That's a secret with a lunatic like Dave Green.
Why, what's his story then?
He's as mad as a hatter. When we see him driving, he runs. When he's caught, he fights. Can't help himself.
But don't we need backup then?
You and me?
Nah.
We'll bang him up for a year, and then wallop. Holiday in Southend.
Yeah, all right, love. Just stay calm, we'll get somebody over to you. Can you give me a few details, please?
How come you never thought of promotion then, Tony?
What?
Promotion. Does it appeal to you?
Nah. I'm happy as I am, thanks.
CID, that's where I'm going.
Well, I hope we're not holding you back.
You ain't got to have a target, haven't you?
I wouldn't make too many rash predictions if I were you. Not in this game. Commissioner, I got something in common.
Both very happy with where we are in the job.
Now, you see, if I thought like that...
Down the road, a disturbance. Anyone free to deal?
Go ahead, then. Sierra Oscar from Sierra Oscar 87.
Yeah, go ahead, Debbie.
We'll take that.
Right, thanks, Debbie. And number 45. Passerbys reported shouting and banging coming from inside. Tenant is a Mrs. Roseanne Lane.
OK, George. On way.
It's Catherine, your mate Debbie.
Well, aren't we going for it?
Ah. I think they got it covered. We'll just hang around here a bit longer.
Mrs. Lane, you've missed him. He's gone. What's so bloody interesting?
Come on, let's go inside, shall we? He was going berserk. I thought he was going to kill Steve.
Did they get him?
No. Are you all right?
No, I'm not. Look what he did in here.
Well, Steve, are you?
Yeah, I'm Steve. Steve Bates.
OK, who are we looking for, then? Do you know the man, Mrs. Lane? Would you recognise him?
Of course she'd recognise him. He's her husband, Phil Lane.
Oh.
You got a problem with that?
It's me. No.
Good.
So what happened?
I called round to see Roz this morning. I work nights. I dropped in on my way back. Phil was just leaving. When he saw me, he went berserk.
I'm not surprised. Bit risky, wasn't it, just dropping in like that?
It's not how you think.
Well, how is it, Roz? Maybe you can let me know.
Phil's my ex. We split up a year ago.
Okay, so?
I think what she wants to know is, what was he doing here at 7 in the morning if you split up? Well?
You're not helping, Mr. Bates.
The man's mental. As soon as he saw me, he started wrecking the place, and I got this.
And you didn't throw a punch, then?
No. I told you, Roz, get a court injunction. Stop him coming near you.
It's worth considering, Mrs. Lane.
I couldn't do that.
Did he stay the night, Roz? Is that what caused it?
Not in the way you think. Nothing happened. We're separated.
Try telling him that. In fact, you can tell him now. He's back. I told you, he's a nutter.
Stay there, please. Watch your back, Debbie. OK, Mr. Bates, why don't you sit down for a minute, eh? Phil Lane!
I just want to tell Roz I'm sorry.
It's over, Phil! You blew it! Roz, don't do this!
It's okay, Phil.
He's turning out against me!
Do you want to tell me about it? Come on.
That's my wife in there.
Your ex-wife. Steve said you attacked him, is that true?
Just get him out of there, will you?
Is it your flat? I mean, I can understand.
Roz!
Very nice. Here we go, look. He's in a hurry, all right? He's getting away. Where's he going? Damn. Put it out over the air. Sierra Oscar from Sierra Oscar 85.
Yeah, go ahead.
Following Blue Granada, Bravo Echo Bravo 955 Yankee, moving east down the...
Get out of the way, Asquith Road!
Asquith Road. He's on the right, he seems. He's running. Got him.
You know what, mate?
No, I don't, mate!
Is that your four Granada parked in Addiscombe Road? Registration number BEB.
955Y, yeah!
Did you drive it here from Asquith Road?
What's it got to do with you?
Right, I'm arresting you for driving whilst disqualified. You
what are you to say doing, anything, you maniac?
But anything you do say may be given in evidence.
Can I have your name, please, sir?
It's Dave Green, isn't it?
No! It's Hardy. Peter Hardy. I bought that car from Dave Green a couple of days ago. If you'd asked me in the first place, I'd have told you.
Oh, yeah? So why'd you run?
I was in a hurry. I'm supposed to be in there delivering that. Now then, what's your number?
Right, Mr. Lane. These officers are going to interview you. Do you want a solicitor present? Your choice. Sign for your property, please. Pretty girl. Who is she? Right, interview room two.
Got it wrong, Nick. I can't just accept it.
What were we told?
Dave Green seen drive...
No, Nick. A man thought to be Dave Green.
You should have checked. You went at it like a bull at a gate.
Yeah, but you built it up, all that talk about running and fire.
Hey, when I was a probationer, I was told to keep these open and this shut. Just get your mind off targets, all right?
Yeah.
Right, Phil, do you want to tell us what you think happened this morning? You can't carry on like this, can you?
I can't believe Roz is seeing someone. Not at a time like this. What's going on?
Well, I know it's tough, but it's no excuse, is it?
I'm not making excuses.
OK, what do you mean, at a time like this?
What are you doing at the flat, Phil, if you and Roz have split up?
Well, sometimes I just go round there. I have to. You know, to be with someone. Roz and I don't hate each other, you know. We're just having a hard time. How is she?
She's upset.
Well, things are worse at night, aren't they, you know? I couldn't sleep, so I went round there. And as I was coming out this morning, Steve Bates comes waltzing in with his own key. Can you believe that?
And?
I don't know. We had a scuffle, I suppose. Does it matter?
Yeah, I'm afraid it does.
Who's the little girl in the picture, Phil? Your daughter. What's her name?
It's Emily. Her name's Emmy.
Has Roz got custody? Don't you see her? Is that what this is about?
Right in my face, telling me I'm banned from driving. What's his problem?
His problem is that he's young, Mr. Hardy, and inexperienced.
Great. What was he before this? A tag wrestler?
Oh, come on.
Listen, this kid had his hands all over me. I don't like that. And it cost me. You lot think you can do just what you like?
Oh, it will be dealt with, believe me.
Of course it will. What will you tell him? Next time, put the boot in? How do I get out of here?
I'll get somebody to show you out.
You don't want to make this official, then?
I'll think about that. I just don't like being manhandled.
Mr. Hardy, what did you mean when you said the delay cost you money?
Ah, forget it.
No, please, I'd like to know. Maybe you're due some compensation.
I was delivering a package. By the time your man had finished with me, I was quarter of an hour late. I didn't get paid.
You're minicabbing, are you?
Well, yeah, that's what I bought the car for.
So you'll have hire and reward insurance?
Yeah. Of course I have. Not on me, but I've got it.
Well, perhaps you'd like to pop in with it and show us then. In the next day or two.
Yeah, whatever.
Forgive me for being fussy, but, you know, a lot of cowboys, they don't bother spending money on the right type of cover.
Great. Intimidated twice in one day.
Sometimes people make mistakes, Mr. Hardy. Overlook the correct procedure, don't they?
Understood.
George.
Sir.
595 from Sierra Oscar.
Go ahead, sir.
Can you and Nick come in and see me before you take your break, please?
It received.
Sarge, we've done the interview.
Right.
There are some more inquiries we could make. I was wondering if we could hang on to Mr. Lane for a bit.
Certainly. Number one.
Just get Steve Bates out of that flat.
I'll change the record, Phil. Tape, Sarge.
Cheers.
Through here.
No joy?
Not really. You're too screwed up to talk about it.
Some blokes get like that when their wives go astray. Unrequited love and all that.
I reckon it's more to do with the daughter than the wife, Sarge.
What's the score, Cass?
Well, he's obviously been throwing his fists about, though he won't say as much. It's not certain who lashed out first, though.
How about the other fella?
Fat lip, black eye.
ABH, then. What do you reckon? See if time heals?
Yeah, I reckon. Never know. Might come up with a neighbour who saw something.
Right, we'll let Phil cool his heels for a bit, then bail him to return next week.
Sarge.
Never get married, Debbie.
Sarge. See? Mm. I thought Phil was going to come right out and admit it for a second. I don't think he cares, frankly. I think he's got bigger problems in his life than this.
What does Sergeant Boyden mean? See if time heals.
Domestics. They're a nightmare. 9 times out of 10, the complainant drops the charge. And if not, the court usually mitigates in favour of the assailant. We achieve nothing.
That's me out of pocket, then. I had a bit on with Nick. £10 for a successful arrest.
Oh, yeah? Well, they're still young.
You are making assumptions, as a result of which I've had earache from a very angry member of the public. Okay, go and get your refs.
Sir.
Hang on, Tony. Tony, you were given a probationer because of your experience. Now just keep you on a tighter rein from now on.
Yes, sir.
If you can't keep up, maybe you'd better do a bit of fitness training. So, Debbie, how are you sitting in at the section nursing?
Fine, thanks.
It's a bit awkward at first, isn't it? You know, not knowing your way around.
It is a bit.
But look, if there's anything you need to know, don't be afraid to ask. You do know I used to be Federation Rep, don't you?
Yeah. Get your wallet out. I've got somebody in custody.
What? Oh, that. Forget it.
Come on. First successful arrest. That was the deal.
Have you charged him?
Not yet.
Well, he's hardly successful then, is it? Anyway, I've got other things on my mind at the moment.
Typical.
Hey, Tony, how's the hip and thigh diet going? Yeah. Or is it the F plane?
You better get some Sellotone, cut some fat off.
Tony.
Cheesham Road Primary School. Lollipop lady's gone sick. I want you and Nick to get down there for 12 o'clock.
Sarge?
Crossing duty.
What's this about then, Sarge?
Pardon?
Rub the puppy's nose in it. Is that the game? Punishment.
For what?
That one's Sarge.
All right, let's start again, shall we? Cheetham Road Primary School, crossing duty, 12 o'clock. And we'll finish this conversation when you've done it, right?
Right. You're up to return here in exactly 1 week. By that time, we should have finished our investigations. It is possible you'll be charged with ABH.
There are signers.
Yeah, sign there, please. You want to behave yourself, Phil, for your daughter's sake, if nobody else's. And stay away from the ex-missus. Save the grief, yeah?
I need to get my car.
Yeah, well, go and pick it up and go straight home.
Cheer up, Phil. We're letting you go. You should get your act together, you know. If your wife gets a court order, you won't be allowed anywhere near her.
Well, she won't.
She's considering it.
She won't. We go back a long way, me and Ros. We need each other.
Yeah, all right, but if you don't give her any reason to, she might not do it.
Time.
What?
Do you reckon Hardy will come back and make the complaint official?
No, I don't. I think he was trying it on. Anyway, you should be more worried about me.
Why?
You dropped me in it with Munro. I don't like
that. Oh, come on, Tony. I said I was sorry. What do you want me to do, crawl?
Nick.
What?
Got another customer.
Yeah, okay, Phil's a loser, but Steve's no great catch, is he?
Nothing's worth all this aggravation. Whether people hang on in destructive relationships, I wouldn't. Clean break, that's the best way.
Voice of experience, eh? I'll tell you what, we're nearly there. We'll have a look, see if it's all quiet, shall we? There we go. Seems quiet enough. Should go and knock.
All units in Sierra Oscar.
Red Escort reported parked in suspicious circumstances at the old waterworks, back of Doral Road.
Can anyone bail?
Yeah, 595. We'll take that, George. Nick!
Yeah, the informant is an old lady, Mrs. Forgan.
She says the engine's been running for a while. The driver appears to be asleep inside.
Sierra Oscar 87, on way. Let's see if we can beat them to it, eh?
Sierra Oscar from Sierra Oscar 85.
Yeah, go ahead, Nick.
We're at the waterworks of Doral Road, located Red Escort, ETA 1 minute.
What do you reckon?
Yeah, I think it's a goer.
From 408.
Yeah, go ahead, Nick.
Ambulance required. Waterworks back of Doral Road. Attempted suicide. Monoxide poisoning.
All right, Nick.
It's Phil Lane.
Oh, no. The car we brought in this morning. Is he going to be all right?
No, that'll do, I know. Check the car, see if he's taken anything else.
408 from Sierra Oscar.
George, it's Kat. I'm on scene now.
Ambulance should be with you in 3 minutes, Kat.
Great, George. Just a domestic. Domestics are supposed to sort themselves out.
Oh, I'm sure it will one way or another. Anyway, we've done our bit.
Have we? Someone's got to tell his wife.
What's he trying to do to me? Why don't you sit down for a bit, eh? I've been waiting for something like this to happen. Has he tried to hurt himself before then, Ros?
No.
He just wants to make me feel guilty, doesn't he? He hates me. Well, I'd say he loves you. He just can't stand seeing you with Steve. Steve's gone. Couldn't take the aggravation anymore. Maybe Phil needed a little more time to get used to you and Emmy leaving him.
You know what dads are like about daughters? Can't bear to let him go, can they?
Emmy's dead. We lost her in a house fire 2 years ago. She was only six. I tried to make a fresh start. Is that wrong? Well, I don't think there's any rights or wrongs, really. Phil wanted us to start again. A family. I couldn't do it. This week is the anniversary of Emmy's death. It just goes off the rails. He can't help himself.
Just got the hospital, eh?
You try to pick up the pieces, don't you? But you're lost. We started drinking more. And then we started fighting.
In the end, we had to split up before we killed each other.
Maybe you shouldn't be shouldering all the guilt.
Perhaps if you take just one day at a time.
That's what Roz says. But it was our fault, you see. We should have been there. We were at a party. All the house was burning. Emma was on her own.
It's down there, I think. You pulled through then, Ross. Sounds like he's going to be all right.
Yeah.
Here we are, look.
Why'd you go and do a thing like this?
I'm sorry. I just couldn't handle it anymore.
Steve's gone. It's just you and me now.
Did a good job, Mick. You'll be mentioned in dispatches. Unless you caught you in gum again. See you in the car 5 minutes.
Yeah, right.
You too, eh?
Did you get the story?
About the little girl. Not the details.
Well, they could have prevented it. According to Phil, they left her on her own while they went out drinking. 6 years old. Oh. House is burning down and they're singing songs on the karaoke. How do you live with that, eh?
I don't know. Bet's off.
Yeah.
You're watching the Bill at 21 weekend here on UK TV Gold, so stay with us as we celebrate Bobbies who've come and gone on the Sunhill beat over a remarkable 21 years. Long-serving coppers June, Reg and Gary relive the golden days next.